Well, it's the first Saturday of deer season, and it is deer season today. Doe season came in, but sister took off today. She's headed back to Alabama with her husband and my nephew, and I've been under the weather the last couple days, so I'm trying to stay in the house, try to get over the crap I have, whatever it is, flu, whatever. But got a good little project for the inside today, cleaning my skull off of my buck and my dad's. Kind of explain how I do things. I'll show them to you here. What I like to do is I like to get them in boiling water first. And I've got one in boiling water. It was in for about a half hour, 45 minutes. I clean it. I'll stick it back in for about a half hour, and then I'll pressure wash it. And that's how I've done the last couple over the last couple years. And mine's already out from being in for a half hour, and dad's is in, been in for about 20 minutes. And I'll show you what they look like. Just a roaster pan. I just have it barely rolling. It's not boiling, bubbling over or anything. A lot of people submerge the horns. If you do that, don't put Clorox or anything in it. Plus, Clorox should be breathing the vapors and stuff. A lot of people put like a gel peroxide on afterwards, which I've never done. Pressure washer gets it pretty good, and then the longer it sits, the whiter it gets. But there's that one. It's been in there for 20 minutes or so. Here's this one. Still quite a bit of stuff on there. Like I said, it's going to go back in for about a half hour. I got as much as I could off with a knife. But I'll pressure wash those, and I'll show them to you what they look like when they're done.
All right, so it's boiled. Still quite a bit of stuff on there. As you can see, pressure washer should take most of it off. It might need to boil a little longer. Might not be able to get it all. But they work pretty slick. Check it out.
Well, this is what the skulls look like after boiling for about an hour and a half a piece, or an hour and 15 minutes, and pressure washing. There's still plenty of stuff on them. It's been a while since I've done that other section of the video, but I want to show you a finished product, kind of where it's at now. But I am going to have to boil them again. What I'm going to start doing once the deer, I mean, once I have the head in there, I'm going to start wiggling the teeth a little bit once it's in the water. And if those teeth start wiggling pretty good, I mean, you'll feel them wiggle a little bit. If they start wiggling pretty good, you're going to want to stop boiling them at that time. And you've probably overdone it if you can, because they'll get to the point where you can pull them right out. But, yeah, there's still plenty of stuff to get off of these. So, boil them. Keep wiggling those teeth, check them out. I've used shotgun brushes to clean stuff out back here in the back side of the skull. Spoons, butter knives, whatever, something just to scrape with. I generally try not to use anything real sharp when I am cleaning up, except for just trimming meat off of the skull. But I try to just kind of, it's more of a rub with like a spoon or something like that. But that's my method. I'm sure someone else might tell you different. So I'll show you what they look like when they're done. Well, here's the finished product. Now they're still wet, and you can still see there's a little bit around the base of the antlers. But I don't know that I've ever gotten every little bit off of them. Pressure washer does a heck of a job, typically. Teeth, you're going to have a little wiggle to them yet, but that'll, when it dries out again, what's left and above those teeth will hold them into place. You get to the point where they're falling out, you boiled it too much. But, I mean, if I pulled hard enough, I'm sure one of those would come out right now. But I'll show them to you again when they're dry. See, there's some on the base there, and someone might say it might be better to completely submerge them, you know, up into here somewhere. But this is how I do it, so I'll show you them again when they're dry. Well, here's what they look like after drying time. Pretty white. You can see some dark spots here still, and that will turn whiter and whiter the longer it sits. Well, this one, a little bit of stuff up around the base of the antlers I didn't get, but I'm happy with that. This up here could have got a little more, but I'm not going to boil it anymore because I think it'll start taking it beyond the point where I'd like it. So things will start rattling around. I want the teeth to be kind of tight on them. And Shane, sometimes, I believe what he does, and I've heard other people say this, they put peroxide gel, and that works out nice, and that's what Shane likes to do. At least I think I've heard him say that. But only one way to figure out how to do it, and that's to try it yourself. Good luck.